what's up, everybody? Welcome back to Unparalleled Universe for another action figure review, and today we're taking a look at the brand new Marvel Legends Deadpool 2 movie version of Cable. And that feels very weird to say because I never thought that we'd get figures from the Deadpool movie universe. The movies came and went, nobody even mentioned action figures, so I kind of got used to the idea that we're living in a world where we would never get any Deadpool movie figures. But then next thing you know, Disney buys Fox, bada bing, bada boom, Hasbro gives us a bunch of Fox movie stuff, and here we are with some Deadpool movie figures. So it's some really awesome stuff, and I'm very excited. So let's go ahead and get into it, starting with this awesome packaging. I love this stuff right here. I like how it kind of looks like it's vandalized by Deadpool. I think that's dope. Behind the scribbling here, it does look like it says Nathan Summers, but Deadpool crossed that out and put Cable, and then he even covered the X-Men logo with his own logo, so that's cool. Up here, he wrote 14 and over, and yeah, that's just really awesome. That's a lot of fun. I like how you could see the figure here with all his accessories, and then behind him there's a big X. That's really dope too. I love all the red on the side of the box. We get a really cool shot of Cable himself, and then on the back of the box we get another shot of Cable. Right here again, it says Nathan Summers, but Deadpool wasn't having it, so he crossed that out and wrote Cable. Down here it says a bunch of bullshit. On the bottom of the box, there's a bunch of bullshit. Over here, we get another shot of Cable that looks really cool. It's the exact same thing that we saw on the opposite side. On the top, we have a Deadpool logo. The packaging is collector-friendly and all that cool stuff, so you can take the figure out and put it back in as you please, but enough about the box. Let's go ahead and take a look at the figure. And so here we have Cable right out of the packaging, and this is definitely a really good-looking figure. I went ahead and put all of his weapons on him because he does have pouches and holsters so that you could store his weapons on the actual figure, so that is always a really good thing. Once you do that, the only thing you really have to worry about finding a place for is the extra hands. But yeah, I love that all the weapons could go on him, and he looks really good. I was surprised by how good the Josh Brolin likeness was. Until I saw it in person, I really didn't think it looked that great. In hand, the face sculpt is really nice. But yeah, I do like the way this figure looks a lot. I like all the pouches. The poncho is cool, but it is a loose piece. And I really wish that they would have put a peg on there so that we could peg it into the figure and then we don't have to worry about it shifting around. As it is now, it kind of shifts around and I never liked that. So I'm probably going to put some tack in there just to keep it in place. I'm almost tempted to glue it, but eventually I probably want to get like a soft goods cape for him or poncho or whatever you want to call this thing. But it does look really good. One thing I will say about this figure, and I don't know if my eyes are deceiving me or what, but I feel like his upper body is a little too narrow. I wish he was a little bit more broad, and I understand why they made it a little bit more narrow. It's because they wanted to add like these overlays and the poncho and stuff like that, but I still wish that his shoulders were a little bit wider. Kind of makes his hips look a little big, you know? But in general, I think it's a really good looking figure. But let's go ahead and get in close and take a look at all the sculpted details, because they did a great job with that stuff too. I think they did a really nice job with the sculpt, especially on the face. To me, this looks exactly like Josh Brolin, and I think they did a great job at capturing his likeness. But let's go ahead and take a look here. Check out all the details. I really like the scars on his face. I like the glowing eye that we have on this side, and it just looks really, really nice. Check that out. That looks exactly like him. So they killed it for sure. And then he's got his goofy haircut with his weird fade. And then for some reason, there's a line in the back of the head on mine. I'm not sure what's up with that. And then the hair looks good too. You can see that it's black, but it's got some detail in there. And for some reason, mine has a little skin showing, but I could just touch that up. Not a big deal at all. But yeah, this head sculpt is really well done. And then I like how we have some cybernetics in the neck. That's dope. And then moving on to the vest here. This vest is really cool. There's not a whole lot of paint detail or anything like that, but it does look good. It's mostly black. There's a little bit of a greenish kind of color in there. I like how we have the magazines, but they are sculpted in there, so they're not coming off or anything. And then the belt looks really cool too. I like how it has this little holster so you could store like the little attachment for his gun. And this does come out, as you can see. Let's go ahead and remove that real quick. So it comes out with no problem at all. And then you can stick it back in there. So that's dope. And this belt is really cool. We've got some pouches and some magazines. And then, of course, he has his daughter's teddy bear. But there's, like, no paint detail on this thing, man. They really should have put some love into the paint, because the sculpt is there for sure. And then back here, he has a holster for his handgun. And this gun is removable, obviously. Well, I guess that's not obvious, because sometimes Hasbro likes to mold the guns into the holster, but this one is removable. But yeah, there's some nice sculpting work on here. I just wish that they would have painted this up to make it look a little better. But that all looks nice. I'm gonna save the arm for last because I have some beef with the arm. but all this is sculpted very well. And then onto the arm here. So this arm is beautifully sculpted. Let's take a look here. The sculpting work is very nice and really well done. But look at this paint job, man. So they put a little bit of silver on the outside and then nothing on the inside. It reminds me of the Ultron Build-A-Figure that they did a couple years ago, where the whole front was painted but the back wasn't. I think that's ridiculous, man. And then they even re-released the Ultron figure with the fixed paint. So you would think that they kind of learned their lesson and they weren't going to do that going forward. But here we are with this kind of shit. You know, I don't like this at all. I really wish that they would have painted the arm. I might just repaint this whole figure, actually, because there's so many nice sculpted details that are just kind of hidden because there's no paint. Like, look at this teddy bear. It's sculpted up. It looks really good. It even has like a bandage. I mean, you know, something like holding it in there that you could see. But there's no paint to bring it out. It's all one color. So that's unfortunate. But yeah, I might have to repaint this or get somebody to repaint it for me or something. And for accessories, Cable does come with a pretty good amount of stuff. First off, we have two different sets of hands. We have a pair of fists, and then we have a set of trigger finger hands. And then he does come with two different guns. First off, he has this big crazy rifle that kind of reminds me of a gun that he would have in the comics. And this is kind of cool because you could like change out some of the parts and stuff like that. And then he also comes with a handgun. And then let's go ahead and take a closer look at his weapon, starting off with this handgun. And this does look good. It's very well sculpted, but there's no paintwork on it. But at least it's an actual gun and not like a Nerf gun or anything like that. And then he has this big ass rifle, which is really cool. And this really reminds me of like something he'd have in the comics but brought to life, you know, because it does look realistic, but you know, at the same time, it's exaggerated and crazy. Like, look at all that stuff that's on there. And then it even comes with attachments that you could put onto the bottom here. I like that a lot. I think that's pretty cool to be able to customize your gun a little bit, and then you could remove that and then put this one on there too. And they just kind of clip onto there. And now for some size comparisons. Unfortunately, I don't have any of the recently released Marvel Legends Fox figures, so I'm just going to have to show Cable off with a bunch of random things. And starting that off, we have Cable alongside the Marvel Legends Walmart exclusive Power and Glory Captain America and the Marvel Legends Amazon exclusive World War II Captain America. And I mean, he looks pretty good next to these guys, but I kind of get torn when it comes to Cable's scale, because Cable as a character is a big, tall, huge, muscular man, and Josh Brolin is kind of like a short, kind of buff dude, you know, like he's not really that tall. So this figure might be accurate to Josh Brolin as an actor, but I feel like he's a little short for Cable. I don't know, that's just me. And so next up, we have Cable alongside one of the Toy Biz Sam Raimi-based Spider-Man figures. I can't even remember exactly what this one is called, but it's still a pretty good figure. It actually holds up pretty well, but I would like to see Hasbro tackle that trilogy. I think it would be interesting to see some modern action figures from those movies. That would be kind of cool, and I feel like it's possible since what they have going on now, like they're going all over the place making figures from all kinds of different movies. So I could definitely see them revisiting that, and it would be interesting. And then on the opposite side of that, we have the Marvel Legends Infinity War War Machine. And now here we have Cable alongside a couple of his comic book counterparts. On the left, we have the Cable that came from the Juggernaut Build-A-Figure Wave. And on the right, we have the Cable that came from the Sasquatch Build-A-Figure Wave. And I still really love both of these figures, especially the one from the Sasquatch Wave. That's a nice figure. And now here we have him alongside the Marvel Legends comic book versions of Deadpool and Domino. And I'm really looking forward to getting the movie versions of both of them, especially Deadpool. That figure's going to be awesome. And to finish off the size comparisons, we have Cable alongside the Marvel Legends Pizza Spider-Man and Marvel Legends Bucky Cap. And now for the articulation, this figure does have a decent amount, and it's probably enough for Cable, but to be honest with you, I wish there was a little bit more going on here, but let's go ahead and take a look. So, first off, his head does move side to side. As you can see, he's using that same style of neck that they used with the Marvel Legends Winter Soldier figure and Marvel Legends Crossbones figure, and I just don't like it, man. It doesn't get very good range. It looks a little better from some angles because you don't have the articulation break that you would have with the hinge joint. But as it is, it doesn't get the movement that I want. So it does move side to side. It does have some tilt to it, which is cool. And it looks down to about right there. And then it looks up to about right there. So if you want to look up and down, your torso is going to have to help you out a little bit. So yeah, not very good range at the neck. I do like that it tilts though. That's cool. And this style of neck would be okay if they gave us movement at the lower neck like they've been doing with the G.I. Joe figures. And in this case, it looks like the neck might be like a separate piece. No, it's not.
Maybe it's all sculpted together. But it seems like they could have made that a separate piece. And they could have got movement at the lower neck. And then I wouldn't mind this head and neck setup, you know. But, you know, it is what it is. And then for the torso, he does have an ab crunch underneath his vest. And it crunches forward to about right there. So that's not too bad considering the whole thing is covered. And it goes back to about right there. And then he does have a waist swivel. And this ab crunch is pretty useful. But I would have preferred a diaphragm cut just because that's a personal preference. I like the diaphragm cut a little bit better. But in this case, this kind of works out because you have the waist and the ab crunch. And any kind of awkward breaks are covered up by the vest. So the torso is okay. And then for the arms, we have ball jointed shoulders. They do go all the way around. They come forward a pretty good amount. Check that out. Looks like there's just enough room kind of cut out there to get his hands like in front of him. So even though we don't have like a butterfly joint going on, we can get his hands in front of him a pretty good amount. So that's cool. I like that. Then his arms do come out to the side to about right there. And then we have upper bicep swivel, double jointed elbow, which gets a really good bend. Bam, that way he could flex. So there you go. And then for his fisted hands, we have a swivel and a hinge. And then for his trigger hands, we have a swivel and then the vertical hinge. Then for the legs, he could kick forward to about right there. He could bring it back to about right there. Come out to the side, a pretty good amount. And then we have upper thigh swivel, double jointed knee. We have a swivel at the boot, which is nice. And then we have rocking ankles that rock side to side. They come forward a really good amount. And then they come up to about right there. So yeah, pretty good articulation there. I would say the only thing I dislike about the articulation setup is the neck. And I would have preferred a diaphragm cut, but I feel like the torso situation that we have going on here is pretty useful. So yeah, like I said, it's a pretty good amount, but there are a couple of things that I wish were a little bit different.
All right, guys. So overall, even though I'm not necessarily in love with this figure, I still like it a lot. And I think that Hasbro did a pretty great job with it. I would say the best thing about it is the sculpted details. They really went all out in that regard. I like the sculpting work on the vest, the belt, the arm is very nicely sculpted. And then the head sculpt is really good. It does a great job of capturing that Josh Brolin likeness. So I am happy with all of that. I do like the accessories that he comes with, the multiple hands, the guns, all of that is good stuff. The articulation is decent. I wish there's a little bit more going on, but for the most part, I think it's okay for Cable. The only thing I kind of dislike, there are a couple of things that I kind of dislike actually. First off, I don't like the paintwork on the arm. I think they got really lazy right there. And they did that back in the day on their Ultron Build-A-Figure, and they haven't done anything like this since. And I kind of thought we were past it, you know, because they even came back around and re-released Ultron with better paint. So it's really surprising that they did the same thing here on Cable's arm where they just painted like part of it. Just doesn't make any sense. So I really wish they would have painted the whole arm. And then aside from that, I do wish the poncho had a peg hole. I think that would have improved this figure a little bit. And then like I said early on, I feel like his upper torso is a little bit more narrow than I would have liked. I kind of wish that he was a bit more broad. But, you know, those are just personal nitpicks. Overall, I think they killed it. They did a great job with it. But for me, I think I would have liked it a little bit more with a couple of minor adjustments. And nothing crazy, you know. I think, you know, the thing about the broad shoulders, that that aspect is okay because you already have all these things on top of it and it kind of makes them look big up top anyway. So I could live with that. But I really wish that the paint was a lot better on this figure. The paint on the head looks nice, but I just wish the rest of the body got the same treatment, you know, especially the arm. That really bums me out. I might have to repaint that. We'll see. But anyways, at the end of the day, I think it's a good figure and I'm very happy to get some stuff from the Deadpool movie universe and I can't wait to get more. So I think that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Please be sure to like, comment, subscribe and all that good stuff. Also be sure to hit the bell notification so that you're notified every time that I go live. And thank you very much for watching. Peace.